try and secure them in a fashion that it works seamlessly. So let me do a quick, I want to just focus on a 5-10 minute demo, but to set the context, apologies for that, to set the context, obviously in platforms like OpenShift, everything is dynamic, right? The IP addresses are dynamic, Kubernetes spins up workloads all the time. So in a context like this, many of your traditional infrastructure elements, like traditional firewalls, traditional IDSs, IPSs, WAFs, all struggle with the fact that now your workloads are dynamic. And especially as you try connecting to platforms outside of OpenShift on virtual machines, you start to have issues with how do you secure your workload. Let me give a tip us. So Tigera as a company has been working with Red Hat on the ecosystem around how do you enable dynamic cloud data security connecting to platforms like OpenShift and also working across the major public clouds. So today, Tigera solutions such as Project Calico and CNX have been embraced by Amazon Web Services, it's been embraced by Microsoft Azure, it's been embraced by Google GKE and IBM Cloud. And in effect, what you get is a consistent security solution that works across all of these. Now, not only is this available in OpenShift, but these major public cloud providers have chosen this as part of the base solution in terms of what they offer customers. So what you get is a consistent network policy implementation that goes across all of these different platforms. Specifically, when you deploy OpenShift today, you get something called network policy, which is something that the Tigera team built for Kubernetes and has been embraced in Kubernetes. So today in Kubernetes, you get a network policy implementation as part of OpenShift. That said, Calico is perhaps, Project Calico, an open source project that Tigera sponsors, is perhaps the premier implementation of network policy across industry. Like I said, it's been embraced by the major public cloud vendors, but also available for OpenShift. And in effect, you get a consistent policy implementation with a whole bunch of advanced features going beyond the base network policy implementation in Kubernetes. Furthermore, recently we announced the fact that Calico policy now includes Istio integration. So when you do security using network and application policy, you actually base that on the application identity assigned to the workload via Istio. And if you're not familiar with Istio, we have a number of sessions at the event here. Specifically, you now have a cryptographic identity that's being assigned to the application by Istio that is leveraged by Calico to enforce policy across the OpenShift environment and also connected to workloads outside of OpenShift. And all of this is done with more advanced enterprise controls, which we'll talk about. And Tigera CNX is that approach to provide the enterprise controls on top of something like Calico working with OpenShift. And specifically, this provides additional RBAC integrations to enterprise sort of hierarchical structures. So you can have an InfoSec team come in and override a developer policy, where you have a network operations team define policies from supersede what a developer or line of business might say. And to actually just give you a quick demo of that, let me actually switch over to the demo, showing the integration of Tigera CNX with OpenShift. So that's the quick login to Tigera CNX. You'll notice the first thing it does, it brings you to the OpenShift console to log in. So if I log in as a developer, I will generally see the network policies that a developer has defined. And so generally that includes things like standard Kubernetes network policies, where I can look at on a policy by policy basis, what is allowed, what is denied. But now let's say I log out as a developer. So let's say an InfoSec team member. Now you notice that in addition to the developer policies, I now have a number of very simple spheres where individual a little further left in that picture the policy is, the higher the priority of that policy. And in effect, this gives you a way to define higher precedence policies organizationally that supersede what an OpenShift developer might define. So that way you're not putting your organization at risk just because of a badly created policy. And each of these, each of these you can obviously get some detailed statistics on workloads that are going through that, how many packets are being allowed and denied at this point, I don't have very much traffic. But I can't see obviously aggregate views in terms of what's happening within the individual policies that are allowing and denying traffic, detailed network statistics and so on. And this is integrated with OpenShift, so typically you can define these policies within OpenShift and be able to create all of these using standard OC command, using the OpenShift dashboard. We saw the login experience, it's all using OpenShift sort of user identification, user identity, OpenShift authentication, authorization using standard Kubernetes all integrated. So this all integrates seamlessly just with the standard OpenShift. Some of the benefits of going with a platform like CNX is that in addition to just doing the basic Kubernetes policy, you do have a lot more advanced controls. In Kubernetes, you can turn a namespace into default API and then allow specific GCP networks. Versus in Calico and CNX, you can do more advanced packet matching, you can log packets, you can do on a policy by policy basis to create policies to create log nodes. Logging packet, you go back and edit what happened at 7 p.m. last night because we can change the policies, what traffic flowed, or what traffic attempted to violate policy. You can also do now with CNX, we actually support multi-cluster. So you can actually have multiple independent clusters of OpenShift, or even an OpenShift cluster talking to Amazon EKS, talking to Azure EKS, talking to Google EKS. Have policy federation going across all of them, which we support in CNX. And because Calico is the policy engine used by the public cloud providers, this gives you a consistent policy communication when you're connecting OpenShift to all of the workloads. Now, all of this doesn't just work on Kubernetes, it also works on virtual machines, it works on host instances, it works on other cloud elements as well. And as an example, the policies are showing in my little demo application there. Come by our booth and we'll show you. A little demo application that we're using where we have this working across not just containers in OpenShift, but also in OpenShift, but also in virtual machines. We actually have this working consistently across even cloud services. This is all being done in collaboration with the big public cloud providers as well. So they actually embrace the kind of resolution for them. Let me stop there. Were there any quick questions right now? Because obviously we're having some technical challenges here with things day one issues. So I'm gonna try and blur for you as we're getting a little bit. Any quick questions I can answer for you, if not really? And we can just stop while we'll give you a more in depth. Thank you.